Friends, I welcome you all to our discussion. Today, we are going to learn the concept of venture capital. Let me share the screen with you. So I think all of you are aware of this concept. At least you must have heard of this concept. Venture capital or venture capital funds, venture capital fund, venture capital investment. Okay, venture capital financing. Let us understand what is that. So at a very basic level, we'll try to understand what is that. What is this venture capital finance or venture capital? So first of all, try to understand that this is a form of private equity finance. So let us, private equity finance, normally it comes in the form of equity. And here some venture capitalists, that means there are some people or some fund, some entities who wants to investment in some new businesses. They may be startup or maybe some kind of maybe risky businesses. And in these businesses, there might be potential of high growth. That is why these people make investment in these sectors. Okay, so normally investment happens in a new business and that too risky. So now if you read it, this particular slide, you will have more clarity on this thing. It's a form of private equity financing. That is provided by venture capital firms, funds. So that means maybe a venture capitalist, maybe a venture capital firm, maybe a fund provides that fund. To whom it is provided? To startups, early stage companies or emerging companies. Startup companies, early stage companies, emerging companies, they face a lot of difficulty in arranging finance. Banks may not be giving them loans because they don't have any track record of profit. They don't have enough asset to give as security. So therefore, bank finance may not be feasible. And therefore, they try for this kind of finance like venture capital finance. So startup companies, early stage companies, and emerging companies opt for this kind of option. And these are the companies which are normally have high growth potential. So they have very good projects. And if money is put or if sufficient capital will be made available to them, there is a potential that they can grow. They will be able to maximize their wealth. Right? So therefore, venture capitalists, they invest money in this kind of risky startups. They understand products, that, let us say, activities has not been started or just initiated or at a very early stage. And risk is there, but growth potential is there. There is possibility of future profit. On that hope, venture capitalists invest money in this kind of project. Okay. Yeah, I think now you're able to listen. So there is a little technical issue. Okay, are you able to listen to me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so we are discussing about the concept of venture capital. Yeah, this means this is the investment in new and tried enterprises. These enterprises may be lacking stable record of growth. They may not be having sufficient asset to provide as security. So arranging debt finance may not be possible for them, right? But there are growth potential, therefore, venture capitalists invest money in this sector. Okay. And when you talk about the venture capital, what exactly means, it is a long-term risk capital to finance high technology projects which have strong growth potential. So this is a long-term investment. Venture capitalists invest money at the beginning stages. Then it exists at a later stage when company becomes stable, when company starts growing. After that only, they withdraw their money. That is depending upon their exit plan, they may go out. So it's a long-term investment. So through these means, through the means of venture capital, funds are made available to startup companies and to small businesses which have exponential growth potential. Okay, money is provided by professionals who also helps in the management. Okay, not that only money is provided, they also assist in managing the company. So this is the basic idea about venture capital finance. When you talk about venture capital company, what we exactly refer, we refer to the financial institution which joins as an entrepreneur, as a co-promoter in the project and shares the risk and reward of the enterprise. Okay, so what is this venture capital company? It's a financial institution who will join as a entrepreneur. That means suppose you are promoting a company and you are looking for a venture capital finance, a venture capital company may become a co-promoter. How it will become a co-promoter? He will be acquiring your equity shares. Some part, maybe 20%, 30%, maybe 10%, maybe 50%, the equity share will be acquiring. That means he will become owner. Once he acquire equity shares, then what will happen? He is sharing the risk and reward of your projects. Whatever reward you will be having as the equity shareholders, he will be getting that thing. Whatever risk you are taking, he is also taking that because he becomes the owner. Okay, so he'll be investing at a fair value, or you will assess the value, what is the value of equity shares at this point of time. Let us say you have just started your company, the value of equity shares might be only face value, might be 10 rupees or 100 rupees as the case may be. At that point, this venture capital company or venture capitalist, venture capital fund is investing money at that value. Okay, venture capitalist may arrive at the fair value of the shares at that point, it will invest. Let us say it's investing at a value of 8 rupees per share. Later on, when company grows, the value of shares may become 30 rupees. At that time, venture capitalists may exit. Understood? And it will happen in long run. Therefore, it's a long-term equity investment in risky projects. Are you getting? Let us say after 10 years, he feels that 10 rupees will become 30 rupees. Then good. That is in 10 years, he is getting 3 times return. Okay, so risk is more, return is also more in case of venture capital investment. The advantage of the company or of the new company which is formed is that he may not be able to get debt finance and he is getting equity finance through a venture capitalist. Understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Generally, the venture capitalist, what it does, finance new and rapidly growing companies. Normally, they purchase equity shares. They also assist in the development of the new products and services. They try to add value through active participation. They also participate in the management because they're the equity shareholders. Okay. They may take part in the board decision. They may become directors also. Okay, they participate and they all act as a co-entrepreneur, co-owner of the company. Okay, and what is a venture capital fund? So SEBI has issued a regulation, that is Venture Capital Fund Regulation 1996. So under that regulation, it has been made clear that a fund established in the form of a company or trust which raises money through loans, donation, issue of securities or units as the case may be and makes or proposes to make investment in accordance with the regulation can be called as the venture capital fund. Venture capital fund, what it does, it may be a company or it may be a trust, it collects money from people. How it collects money? Maybe in the form of loans, maybe form of equity, maybe in the form of issuing units. And that money is gifts. And what will be use of that money? It is intended to be used as a venture capital investment. That means that money can be used for acquiring equity shares of a new or risky projects. So that is the meaning of venture capital fund. Okay, it's a definition as per SEBI regulation 1996, that is the meaning. Right. Now let us see the characteristics of the venture capital investment. It has a long-term horizon. That investment is for long term. Investment normally made in equity form, but there is also possible investment can be made in convertible debts. That means initially debt, then it can be converted into equity. Or it can be also given as long-term loans. But normally it is an equity. It lacks liquidity. That means immediately you can withdraw. You cannot withdraw. If you are investing money, you cannot withdraw it because it's a long-term investment. It involves high risk, high growth potential. And normally venture capitalists participate in the equity. So it's an equity participation. Venture capitalists join as a co-promoter. It shares the risks and reward. Is expected to have continuous involvement in the company for commercialization of new ideas, technology. Involvement is required, and the venture capitalists also participate in developing new ideas and technology management. And once the venture reached the full potential, that venture capitalist would like to divest his holding. He would like to exit now. So not only injection of money, but also input needed for setup of the farm, designing, some marketing strategy, organizing plan, etc. So all these regular managerial activities also venture capitalist participate. Usually investments are made in the small or medium scale farms. Right. It has got lot of advantages because growth is high, of course risk is high, growth rate is high, and money can be invested for a long time. Once, and here is a chance to invest or become a business partner. These are the advantages of venture capital investment. Okay. Now let us quickly learn various stages of venture capital finance. Several stages are there. First, we'll understand what is the concept of seed money. So at the time of development of idea, this money is given. Venture capitalist, this money that is called the seed money or initial money, which is given. So venture capitalist invest money in various stages. Next step is the startup. At the stage of implementation of the project, money is given. That is called the startup investment. Then maybe fast route investment. Okay. At the time when I can say early stages of manufacturing or sales, this money is given to the first round. Second round money is given at the stage of establishment when you need more working capital, you want to extend your production facility. Second round money can be given. Then third round money is also called as the mezzanine finance. This is also given for expansion purposes. Okay, so if you want to expand your business, then this money that can be obtained. Then the fourth round is the bridge financing. That means before going to public, money can be given by the venture capitalist. So now you have seen there are six stages normally at which money is given. So I repeat once again, seed money at the development of ideas, at the stage of development of ideas, startup funding, that is at the stage of implementation, first round at the time when the sales and manufacturing starts, early stages of sales and manufacturing. Second round, when working capital is needed, that is also at early stage. Now, third round, at the time when expansion is needed. Fourth round, just before going to public, that is called the bridge finance. So these are the stages at which money is financed through the process of venture capital finance. And at each stage, risk is different. And the seed money, there is extreme risk is there. There is no guarantee that money will be recovered, company will be successful. Startup stage also, risk is very high. And first stage finance, risk is also high. Second stage finance, risk is sufficiently high. Third stage, medium level risk. And fourth stage, you see low level risk. So venture capitalists assess this kind of risk on that basis makes investment. So as you see, the investment is normally at the time when you give it seed money, you might have to wait for 7 to 10 years. Startup stage, you might have to wait up to 9 years. First stage, maybe you have to wait up to 7 years. Okay, then second stage, maybe after 5 years, we are expecting that you will be able to exit. Third stage, maybe 1 to 3 years. Post is maybe 1 to 3 years. Okay, so like this, different stages involve different risks and different lock-in period. Okay. Now, how venture capitalist makes investment, these are again process, you can have a look. First, venture capitalist make a deal with the organization. Try to contact the organization, negotiate with them. Then do a kind of screening, decides that through the screening, be able to select whether this will be investing money in that company or not. Conducts his own due diligence, he evaluate the company. Then he structure the deal. What will the plan, how much money will be invested for how much of equity, what is the exit plan. Then post-investment activities, how he will be able to manage the company, how money will be released. Then finally, exit plan. Venture capitalist decides to exit. So these are, you can say, process of making investment by the venture capitalist. You can have a look here. First, you can think of this chart also. First, one has to look for the opportunity, then initial screening, then due diligence, then negotiate, then fund can be released in various stages. Okay, not that just on the basis of a proposal, fund will be released. So after due diligence, after initial screening, after evaluating the proposal, venture capitalists release the fund. Did you understand this? Is it clear up to this?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Now, let us quickly learn various methods of venture capital financing, or you can call it as the types of venture capital financing. Now, you know, normally, finance is made through equity, but it's also possible to bring venture capital in the finance through conditional loans, loan attached to certain conditions. Okay, like this, for example, there will be no repayment for initially this much year, this much will be rate of interest, like this. Okay, so conditional loans. Income loans. Income loans means investment will be given and regularly the company has to pay some income to the investor. Participating debentures. Participating debentures means basically it is a debenture, like a loan instrument. Interest will be paid. But in addition to that, the holders of these debentures are also eligible to participate in the profit. Okay, so this is again a kind of hybrid instrument kind of thing. Just like equity shareholders, you are participating in the profit and also you are getting interest. That is called as a participating debenture. Quasi-equity means semi-equity. Maybe you can call them as convertibles. Convertibles means initially you maybe issued debentures for 5 years. After that, it will be converted into equity shares. That is called as a quasi-equity. Initially, they will behave like a debt instrument, but later on, they will be converted into equity. So these are various methods through which venture capital financing is obtained. Is it clear to you, friends?
Yes, sir.
Now, next is about exit route. That is also important. How there is a venture capitalist has invested money, how you will be exiting. These are various possible routes. One is IPO. If the company is coming up with IPO, at that time, venture capitalists can dispose of, can quit the company at market price. Or trade sell or sell over the counter. That means it can, over the counter, it can sell its equities and leave the company. Promoters buy back. If the promoters want, they can buy back the shares of the venture capitalists at the high price and venture capitalists can quit. And sometimes the shares may be acquired by another company. Another company may be interested to buy the shares of the venture capitalist or venture capital investor. And through that process, venture capitalist may exit. Or management buyout. If management team decides to buy out the shares of the venture capitalist, the venture capitalist can exit. So these are, you see, 5 possible exit plans through which venture capitalist can exit. So that means you have understood that venture capitalists can enter into the company as an investor, as a co-owner, as an equity investor, when the share price might be low, profit might be low. But later on, when the company grows, value of the shares goes up, you may exit according to the exit plan. This is the concept of venture capital financing. Okay. And if you at all, if you're interested, then you can search in the net and find out various kinds of what is the development of venture capital industry in India, what is the list of venture capital funds. All these things are available. Examples of venture government's initiative as regards to venture capital, but the rules and regulations of venture capital in India. So all these things on your own interest, you can learn. Many data is available in the net and the SEBI website also. You can find it. Is it clear to all of you? Up to this, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. Thank you very much.